Jess and I have got a bit of a confession to make. We don't wake up looking like this every day.
No. Not at all. Normally, I'll have very puffy eyes.
Yeah.
And creases on my face.
We have a team of magical fairies that come along and sprinkle all sorts of things on our face to make us look camera ready.
Yep.
It's a wonderful team here at Network 10. But we have one of them here today, one special makeup artist who's going to show us how to solve all of our eye problems. She is a 10 makeup artist. We have Celestina, her assistant, here as well. Yeah. Renee, we're talking smoky eyes. Does a smoky eye suit everyone?
It does, actually, and it's the most requested makeup as a makeup artist that we do get. It's one of those things that brings sexiness, it brings confidence, it brings seductiveness. So lots of people ask for that smoky eye for their night out.
How can you do it without it looking like someone's
really
drawn on
smudgy.
Your face?
Well, this is what we're going to show you today.
Okay.
We're going to go through all the tips with Celestina. Mm-hmm. So I'm going to start off first, and we're going to use a crayon, which is an eye paint. Now, the reason why I use this before I start any smoky eye is because it helps stick the eyeshadow to the eye. What happens when we do any eyeshadow, throughout the day it smudges and it gets stuck in our creases. You know, we go through all that hard work and effort and then it disappears by lunchtime. So what we do, we get our crayon pencil and we're just going to colour in just straight over the lid.
The whole lid?
The whole lid and just straight up to that little crease.
Does it matter what colour you use for that?
No. So what I tend to do when I use a crayon, I match it with what tone I'm going to go.
Okay.
So you can do this for daytime and use lighter colours, or you can do it for nighttime where I'm using a bronzy colour. So this one can morph from daytime to nighttime at the same time.
But you'd hold the black to nighttime.
Hold the black for nighttime, definitely. Right. So my next step is to set that, I'm going to get my brown eyeshadow and I'm just going to dip my eyeshadow brush into there. Okay. And I'm just going to place it on top. And so what this is doing, just like when you put foundation on your skin and you put powder on top of it,
it's setting it in.
That's right.
And you have to hold it down very far, like your eyelid. Sometimes it can be tricky to do that because you're blinking.
Well, you've got to be careful because when you hold it down, you can drag.
Yeah.
So you don't want to drag the eye. The secret to a good smoky eye is always trying to keep the eye lifted up. Right?
So you press that down.
Don't drag it down, Sel.
Yeah.
Hold it up. Yeah, lovely.
That looks really good.
So, and also, when we're pressing it in, we're trying to add colour. By using a paint first, you're getting the most pigment out of your eyeshadow that it's going to give you. So, pressing it in rather than smudging it, because we don't want it to go crazy and go everywhere. Okay, and we're going to stop there. We're going to then pick up a blending brush. Now, you have to have a blending brush when you do a smoky eye.
Do you?
Because it helps buff out any hard lines. Right now I've got very hard lines and we need to get rid of those hard lines to create the smoky effect. And that's what does the smoky effect is a blending
brush. And you can
get
blending brushes, chemists,
you can get them
the supermarket.
These days,
you can,
definitely.
And what's the key to a blending brush? It's sort of fluffy.
Nice, fluffy,
yep.
Smoky, fluffy brush.
Okay.
Nice and soft.
Blend is your friend.
Blend is your friend. Okay.
Right.
And what you're going to do when you blend, you're going to look straight into your mirror and you're going to place it right in that crease, in that socket, and you're just going to roll it back and forth, three quarters of the way through and back, until you create no hard lines and it's all soft. Right?
Oh, wow.
So it's almost like an eraser at the same time. Right?
So like a window wiper.
Yeah. So as you can see now, I have no hard, stripy lines and everything's going into the nice direction it should be going into. Now, we want to intensify it a lot more. So we're going to pick up our black pencil.
Glitter.
I'd love to add glitter. So we're going to get our black pencil and we're just going, not a perfect line. It doesn't have to be perfect at all. And we're just going to scribble it along our lash line. This just creates depth for our lashes and a little bit more drama. So you can see that's not perfectly straight. But then I pick up my flat brush again and I'm just going to dip it back into my dark shadow and just go straight over the top of that.
Because this is, I think, where sometimes people go wrong. You put too much dark and then you end up with panda eyes.
That's right. And it's A massive secret is to start closest to the lash line and work your way up. That way you've got room to work. Okay. If you start up here, then you only have that much room between your eyebrow and your eye. Mm-hmm. So you want to start close to the lash line and blending it and buffing it all the way up to your corner and back into that crease again, nice and round, blending it out. It's all about the blending. And you've got your solid formation for a first bit of
that
eye.
That looks beautiful.
You've got your girlfriend's on the phone. They're in the cab. They're outside waiting to go out to drinks with you. The babysitter's here. You've got to finish your eye real quick. What do you do?
Finish it off. End it with a smoky eye. Black pencil in the inner rim on your waterline.
Ooh. Oh, I don't like that.
Yeah, that can be a little bit icky at times.
Or waters. To me, it can sometimes make your eye get more watery.
But it does make your eye look very dramatic and very sensual.
Yes, but you have to watch the corners.
Yes, the teeth.
You have to watch the corners.
Yeah.
But that's the secret. If you're using this just on the outer eye, it's just giving you a nice dark corner in there.
Oh, just look down the barrel for a second. Look how gorgeous that looks. Mm. And you can wear that day to night.
Yeah.
Renee, wow. Always good to see you.
Thank you
for making us look this way every day. Thank you.